everyone. Today in Sanghi's Cookery, we're going to see how to prepare a double beans kurma. So double beans are very rich in protein, iron and other dietary fiber. And this is a great boon for all the vegetarians. And we can prepare a lot of dishes out of double beans. So today we're going to see about the kurma, but we can add this in sambar or in any vegetable, or you can make a chundal out of it. Or even when making the pulao or biryani, if you add double beans, it's definitely going to add to the taste and flavor of the dish. So before we go into the procedure as to how to prepare this double beans kurma, if you're watching my video for the first time, I would request you all to subscribe to my channel and also click on the bell icon for further interesting recipes and notifications. For making the double beans kurma, I've taken the fresh double beans. So the fresh double beans will be something like this, pink in color. Otherwise, you can even get the dried double beans in the market. If you're going to use a dried double beans, then you need to soak it overnight and then pressure cook it. But since this is fresh double beans, I'm not going to soak it. I'm just going to directly give one whistle by adding little bit of salt in pressure cooker. This is approximately around 250 grams of the double beans after which is being peeled. So I'm just not going to discard the water. I'm just going to keep the water also for the gravy. Two onions finely chopped, two green chilies slit, one tablespoon of poppy seeds and the cashew nuts. Around 3 to 4 numbers of the cashew nuts, which has been soaked in hot water for about 20 minutes. So I'll be grinding 4 to 5 teaspoons of coconut, half a teaspoon of fennel seeds or the sauf, and half a teaspoon of jeera along with the poppy seeds and cashew nuts into a smooth paste. Oil required for frying, and for the masala powders, 1 tablespoon of the dhania powder, half a teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of chili powder, half a teaspoon of black pepper powder and 3/4 teaspoon of garam masala powder, some finely chopped coriander leaves, some curry leaves, 3 tomatoes chopped. Instead of just adding the ginger garlic paste, for that I'm just making a paste of these 3 ingredients, which is 2 pieces of ginger, 11 flakes of garlic and 5 to 6 small onions. For the seasoning, 1 teaspoon of jeera, 1 teaspoon of sauf and 2 to 3 cinnamon sticks and 2 to 3 cloves, half a teaspoon of jeera powder, about 2 tablespoons of oil. So once the oil gets heated up, I'm adding the whole masalas, which is the jeera, the sauf, the cinnamon sticks and the cloves. You can even add a bay leaf. After the whole masala gets fried, I'm just adding the green chilies, which is lit, and also the finely chopped onions. I'm going to add some salt for the onions to get cooked faster. While the onions are getting fried, we'll just grind the small onions, garlic and the ginger into a smooth paste. At this stage, I'm also going to add some fresh curry leaves. Cook this for a few minutes. So you can see that the onion and the ginger garlic paste and the green chilies and curry leaves have nicely been cooked. It's been about 6 to 7 minutes. I've been frying this. Now we're going to add the tomato. Taken around 3 tomatoes. I've grated it and I've added the tomato. While the tomatoes are going to get cooked, I'm going to grind a few ingredients in the mixie jar. I've taken around 4 teaspoons of coconut. This is very little coconut, just for having a binding for the gravy. Half a teaspoon of jeera, half a teaspoon of sauf. And I'm going to add this couscous and the cashew. And I'll be grinding this into a smooth paste. After about 5 minutes of frying the tomatoes, I'm going to add the masala powders, which is half a teaspoon of turmeric powder, chili powder, black pepper powder, dhania powder, roasted jeera powder. Mix it up nicely and we can close this and cook for a few minutes. In about 5 minutes, you can see that the tomatoes have nicely cooked and the oil is also coming out from the sides, you can see. So at this stage, I'm going to add the cooked double beans. See, the double beans has been cooked nicely. If you just press it lightly, so you can see that it's cooked nicely. I'm adding it here. And also, I'm going to add the ground coconut paste. So now, we can even adjust the gravy by adding some water in the mixie jar. So now, let this cook on a medium flame for about 6 to 7 minutes. At this stage, you can check for salt and if required, you can add some more salt. I've already added salt in the double beans while cooking it. So I'm just adding some salt for the gravy. Let's cover this and cook it. So finally, I'm just going to add some garam masala powder, say about a teaspoon of garam masala powder, and some fresh coriander leaves and curry leaves. Mix it up nicely. Then we can switch off the gas, and our double beans kurma is ready. We can transfer this to the serving bowl. So finally, I'm going to decorate this with some coriander leaves and some fresh curry leaves as well. So I hope you'll try out this double beans kurma. It will go very well with rotis, parathas, fulkas. So I hope you'll all try out this recipe, and if you like it, please share it with your friends and relatives. Have a great day.